I had no idea I left out the biggest part of how this is really just proof of the rapture. Wow. Noah and his family were saved from that flood and were told to go into the ark. Sit down. Just sit down. You're going to need to. Especially you guys who think those who believe in the rapture. I mean, y'all can be real disrespectful. We're all believers in Christ together. And quite frankly, there's got to be some kind of darkness in you, honey, for you to sit there and say the things that you have about those who believe in the rapture. We believe in the rapture because of Scripture. Pray that you are worthy to escape these things. Scripture would not tell us to pray that we are worthy to escape these things if there was no possibility to escape these things. God does not contradict himself. God had Noah and his family going to the ark. God shut the door behind them 7 days before the flood. What? 7 days before the flood. Oh my goodness. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete. Days before the flood. 7 days before the flood. How long is the tribulation? 7 years. Pray that you are worthy to escape. And that you will be able to stand before the Son of Man. Before the flood, he had Noah and his family go into that ark. You can come up with whatever you want to say there is no rapture. But never in the history of anything has God ever sat there and had his righteous sons and daughters go through judgment. For thousands of years, us who are followers of Christ and us who have worshiped the one true God, we have faced persecution and death and mockery and scoffing and torture and hell and tribulation. For thousands of years, we have been facing that. That 7 year tribulation, you know why God says vengeance belongs to him? Now. It's going to be on those who cast and caused tribulation for everyone who followed Jesus Christ. And you know what? A lot of those people who hate us because we believe in Jesus, they don't even know why. And you would think they would sit down and wonder, man, that's weird. I really don't like them. And I don't even have a reason, you know, it's kind of weird. You would think somebody would think, but apparently not. Noah and his family were told to go into that ark, and God shut the door behind them 7 days before the flood. Just like in the days of Noah. At the time of the coming of the Son of Man, it will be likened to the days of Noah. If you even read your Bible, and you even know anything about prophecy, you don't even have to know much at all. But one of the most crucial things is that prophecy parallels. It repeats itself. What was done is what will be done, and what is done is what shall be done, and there is nothing new under the sun. Just as Noah and his family were put and were told to go into that ark, and God shut the door behind them 7 days before the flood. Here, let's count together again. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete. Days before the flood. One, two, three, four, five, six, and 7 days before the flood. Wow. On the last video I made talking something about this, right when I just felt the unction that I had said everything I need to say, I got to 3 minutes and 33 seconds. Just now, I got to 4 minutes and 44 seconds. And you know what's crazy? I was completely confident when I made that video about Noah, but you know, people just, they make it, they, everybody's got their valid reasoning why they feel like there's not a rapture. They're not saying it just to say it. They got their valid reasoning, but what they fail to understand is we also have ours. We're not just trying to escape our problems. We're all believers in Christ together, but the difference between us who believe in the rapture and those who don't is all of those who don't believe in the rapture, y'all have been literally causing division among the bride of Christ with your accusations and disrespect and false witness against us who believe in the rapture, accusing us of trying to escape our problems and accusing us of believing in a deception, which is absolutely ridiculous. Does it need to be any more simple? God makes it real simple. Yes, in the day of the coming of the Son of Man, it will be like in the days of Noah. Jesus, that's not mentioned just because that would have never been mentioned and correlated to if only part of the days of Noah would be similar to the coming of the Son of Man. It would have to be the entire days of Noah on Noah's side and the whole world who was unrighteous. Really? Really? Come on. Noah and his family were told to go into that ark 7 days before the flood. Yeah. 7 days before the flood. Ooh, my face looks oily. This is Neosporin on my face because I got acne and I crave sweets all the time. And if I eat too many sweets, then I get this. So that's why I look nasty and oily. I'm sorry, you guys. I should wipe that off first. But I just, man, I jumped out of my skin and like flew down the hallway. I was like, I got to tell them this because, oh my goodness. So, 7 days before the flood. Scripture wouldn't tell us pray we are worthy to escape if there was no ability to escape in the first place. And it's kind of, it's like a, you're, it's such a disrespect to God in a sense, in my opinion, I feel. To think that God would make those of us who have already been facing tribulation, we are not appointed to God's wrath. You understand that, right? The 7-year tribulation is God's judgments and his wrath. We are not appointed to wrath. Goodness me. Like, people think they're just, you know, there will be no rapture. We'll have to endure the 7-year tribulation. Like they're excited and proud about that thought or something. Do you not understand what you're saying and coming to agreement to within yourself? You have taken the blood of Christ upon yourself, right? When you become a believer in Christ. You accept him as your Lord and Savior. You give your whole life to him. Your life is in his hands, and you know it's secure. And you still think you're going to have to endure a great tribulation and face the 7 trumpet judgments as if the blood of Christ upon you hasn't made you righteous, as if the blood of Christ upon you deserves to have to go through a 7 trumpet judgment and deserves to have to be appointed to God's wrath when he is completely holy and righteous and innocent. And even so, he still already took all of our sin upon himself, defeated death, sin, and the grave already, and said, it is finished. 7 days before the flood, Noah and his family were told to go into that ark. And when the flood came, they went up, Maranatha.